Hey, 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 everyone. Blockchain Bernie here with my latest episode. And this is my third video about my Web3 scenarios. I've already shown you my bull case, my bear case, and this one's the last one, my mid-range case, right? And this doesn't mean that this is the realistic case, right? It simply does not mean that. I gave you three scenarios that I think all three are possible. And I'm not saying the middle one is the most likely. I'm an optimist. I feel the bull case is the most likely to happen for good reasons. And even it could be even more than the bull case. But now let's talk about my mid-range case. Let's dive right into it. So first of all, I want to recap why Web3 is going to happen either way, whether in the bull, the bear, or the mid-range scenario, the cost of storage on smart contract chains is crazy high, as you see here. It's literally going to cost billions of dollars just to store data on the blockchain with smart contract blockchains. So, and we're moving towards more decentralization. People want to, you know, be in control of their own destiny. That's a trend that has been going on for thousands, if not millions of years on this planet. And that trend is going to continue. All right. So I give you a recap of my bull case. The other video, you've seen it already. So in this case, Web3 is going to overtake, to surpass Web2 in 2028. And you will see like a, you know, 150x of the market cap and the market size of Web3 over the next 5 years. So that's my bull case. I personally feel this is the most likely to happen. Then we've had the bear case, right? With the bear case, we still, and it's another video about my bear case. I explain everything there, why these assumptions are there, but it is still like a 13x of the market size and market cap of Web3, even in the bear case. This video is about the mid-range case, and you see it here. It's still more than 130x of the current market size of 20 billion in the beginning of 12, you know, in the middle of 2023. This 26 is when 2023 is finished. So we are still in that mid-range case. And look at the graph here, right? It means Web3 in 2028 is still in its infancy in this mid-range case, right? It's still way, way smaller than Web2. And the Web2 market size includes all the e-commerce that's out there, right? And that's happening on Web2 these days. This mid-range case, in my opinion, it can happen. You know, things can go wrong, and Web3 just cannot live up to expectations. We cannot get it done technically or stuff like that. But even in this mid-range case, you will have like a 100, and more than a 100x of the market size of Web3 over the next 5 years. All right. So these are all three scenarios. Let me know down in the description what you think, which one of these cases is the most likely. I want to know in the comments from you, and let me know why. I really want to discuss it. This is the third video of the series. I've shown you my bull case, my bear case, and now my mid-range case. Please like my video if you enjoyed it. It really means a lot to me. Subscribe to my channel as well. There's more content to come. And thanks for watching so far, and catch you guys later. Bye.